Hey there, Casey Dim here, TaxSolAcademy.com, your quick tip today. And today we're talking about repairs. What happens when you buy a tax sale property, a structure, a house, or a commercial building of some sort, and it needs all sorts of repairs? A lot of beginners get the impression, for whatever reason, that if they buy a piece of property that needs repairs, that they're the one that has to go in there to fix the toilet and take a hammer and, you know, paint it and all that good stuff. And it's just not true. When a piece of property needs repairs, you have two options. Number one, you hire subcontractors or a contractor, you go in there and you fix the property and you sell it. You flip it more than anything. It's kind of like a remodel, like this TV shows, that kind of thing. But option two is what a lot of my students and myself do. They buy it at such a good price that they resell it without ever touching the repairs. They don't handle the repairs. They sell that to another flipper. They sell it to somebody that is going to handle all of that stuff themselves. There's absolutely nothing wrong with taking the time and the money to invest in a piece of property to handle these repairs and then flipping it and getting more money. But again, a lot of people, a lot of my students, myself, we like to buy properties, and if you buy them correctly, if you buy them the way that I teach, at least, you'll be able to have enough room there, enough margin to sell it to somebody else very quickly, let them handle the repairs, and then you can go on to the next property. And you don't have to worry about lifting a hammer or hiring a single person. So again, you can repair it or not repair it. The choice is yours. Just don't feel obligated that you personally have to go in there and paint the house or whatever it may be. That's all I've got for today, folks. For more information on tax law investing, head on over to TaxSolAcademy.com. Take care, bye.